I'm Amberly, and I'm so glad you're here. In this video, we're going to be doing something really special, initiating you into the ranks of Real Programmer by writing a program called Hello World. Hello World is a classic first program when you're starting to work with a new language. Over the course of your journey as a developer, you will probably write at least a dozen Hello World programs. But what's with writing the same program over and over?
In 1978, a book called The C Programming Language was released. It was the first of its kind, and inside was a tutorial that readers could follow on their own that would demonstrate the functionality of the C language. This tutorial program was called Hello World. Readers were encouraged to write the Hello World program not only to give them experience using the syntax of the language, but also just to ensure that the computer was able to successfully compile the program. Since that was back in the day of unreliable technology, programmers always checked the compiler before sinking a bunch of time into something that, ultimately, they may or may not be able to run.
Even though technology has come a long way since then, Hello World is still the OG program to write when you're learning a new language. It's simple, it's classic, it's timeless, and it'll never go out of style. Just like pearls. All right, are you ready to be a real programmer? Let's do it. I'm a firm believer that when you're learning a new skill, it's important to develop good habits right off the bat. So before we start coding, we're going to discuss some good habits that all pro developers should have. Your future bosses are going to thank me for this. It all boils down to clean, organized code. Developers pretty much always work in teams, which means that at some point, you're going to be working on code that you didn't write, and someone else is going to be working on the code that you've written. So how do we keep our code professional?
The first way is by following industry standards around the structure of a program, essentially how it's laid out. Take a look at this recipe card. This is a simple recipe for biscuits. Now, whether or not you cook a lot, you can probably read a recipe. And that's because all recipes are pretty much written in the same format. This format is also known as a convention. A convention is just a standardized way of doing something, and programming, we love our conventions. According to recipe card convention, at the top, we have all the ingredients that we need to prepare the dish. Beneath that are the step-by-step instructions for how to prepare the ingredients. And then finally, at the bottom, you have the serving instructions. It might seem redundant to have serving instructions on this recipe because obviously biscuits are best served warm, so why is it printed here? Because that's just how you write a recipe card. It's the convention. Believe it or not, the convention for a program structure is actually very similar to that of a recipe card. So here I am in Visual Studio, and we installed this in our last video. I've got my new project set up, I've got my source code here, I've created my source file, and we are ready to start coding. If you're going to follow along with me in this video, go ahead and pause now and then resume when you're ready. So let's think back to our recipe card. What was the first thing on that when we started out? At the top, it's our ingredients, right? Well, in programming, we have a similar thing, except we call them libraries, and sometimes we need to bring those in and use them to make our final product. Okay, to add a library to our program, we're going to start by typing in the pound symbol and then the word include. And then we're going to put in a set of carrots. Now, you recognize these as the less than greater than symbols, but in programming, we refer to them as carrots. Now, between these, we're going to put in the name of the library that we want to bring into our program. And today, it is going to be the IOStream library. And you can see Visual Studio is trying to help us out here with that prompt. When you guys see this appear, if it's selected the option that you want, go ahead and press Tab, and it'll kind of auto-complete it for you, which is really cool. All right. Now, our next ingredient that we need is using namespace std. And don't worry too much right now about what that does for us. Just know that it's a required ingredient for our program. Now that we have our ingredients together, it's time to move on to the main part of our recipe, which is going to be the instructions. As we know, the instructions are where kind of the majority of like the meat of the recipe lies. So we are going to do that here by creating a function called int main. Okay, we type it out just like this. Now, between these two curly brackets right here is where all the cooking's going to happen. But since this is a program and not a recipe, we do need to add two lines down here at the bottom. Don't worry too much right now about what those do as far as the functionality of the program. Just know that we have to have them here as part of our int main function, or it won't work properly. So what we have now, guys, is basically like a blank recipe card, right? We've got our like ingredients, our instructions area. We just need to go ahead and put those in here. So what I recommend is actually taking a minute to save this as a template if you're following along, because this is going to be, just like the recipe card is a, you know, just a standard template, this is going to be the basis for all of your programs moving forward. So everything that we build in this video series is going to need just at least this structure right here. And now that we have this set up, it is time to get cooking. So the functionality of the Hello World program is actually pretty simple. It just prints out the words Hello World onto the screen. Now, in our last video, we actually learned that in Visual Studio, that screen is called the console. So in order to make that happen for us, we need to add some instructions. In C++, printing to the console is done with a command called console_out, which we actually write as cout. This tells the compiler that whatever is going to follow is intended to be shown on the console. Before we can type out the literal text that we want to appear on the screen, we need to add two left-facing caret. And this just kind of indicates to the compiler that we're switching gears. So cout is a command, and now we're kind of changing to something else. What we're changing over to is known as literal text. And to indicate that, we're going to go ahead and put a set of double quotes here. The quotes tell the compiler that whatever we put between here needs to be printed to the console exactly as we type it. And actually, that's why we call it literal text, is because whatever I type in here is going to print to the console exactly as I type it. So if I put, for example, just like a million spaces in here, you know, we might not be able to see it because it's just spaces, but it will print that out to the console. This is a good thing to remember when you're doing display stuff. So if you type something in here and you're like, oh, it just looks a little funny, I need some more spaces, you can do it right here with the cout command. Now, what we actually want to be in here for our program is going to be Hello World, right? Now we just need one more thing.
Did you know that just like spoken languages, programming languages have proper syntax too? For example, you wouldn't tell someone, I go store, right? You would say, I'm going to the store, or I went to the store, because that's the proper syntax in the English language. Well, just like English, C++ has to adhere to a proper syntax and structure to be able to speak to the computer properly. Remember earlier when we added carets to transition from our cout command to literal text? That was an example of adhering to C++ syntax.
Now, just like any language, C++ does have a syntax. So in English, we end our sentence with punctuation, and in programming with C++, a sentence is known as a statement, and it also requires some ending punctuation. So for us, that is going to be a semicolon. All right, guys, awesome. So we've written our first program. We have our command here, cout, which is saying print this literal text here to our console. So we are ready to run this baby. Let's do it. I'm going to click on my local Windows debugger. Here we go. Boom, and there you have it, guys. Hello world. Awesome. Congratulations, everyone. Welcome to the official ranks of programmer. I am so proud. But before we celebrate, aren't we forgetting something? If we think back to our recipe card, what are we missing? Serving instructions. Now, we thought those were obvious, right? So maybe we should think of them instead as how to enjoy what was made instructions. In programming, we call these comments. So I'm going to go ahead and close out our console here and go back to Visual Studio. Now, you can think of comments as the serving instructions for other developers. So we leave them here to tell other programmers how to use our code. So each program that you write should have a minimum of two comments left at the top of it. So I'm going to move this down just a little bit, okay? And we're going to start with our comment by doing a backslash and then an asterisk, which is shift and then the 8 key, all right? And so now we have this nice little, it filled it out for us here, and this is green. And this is how you indicate a comment. So anything that I write between here, the compiler knows that it's not going to try and execute it or anything like that. So the first comment that you need to have is your name. So you just need to label your work. The next is going to be a program description. And this tells what this program does. So this program prints Hello World to the console. Short and sweet. One of the biggest questions that I get asked about comments is, what should I comment?
So to answer the question, what should I comment? The answer is, you should comment on anything that you think another developer might want or need to know if they had to make a change to your program. Since we are developing good habits, let's go back and comment our Hello World program before we wrap up. But make sure to stick around to the end. I have something for you.
So taking a look at our program, if we need to comment on anything or anywhere that a future developer might want to make a change, well, in this one, we really only have the one functionality right here, right? So this is all it really does. So this is where we would leave our comment. And I'm just going to say here, prints literal text to console. Awesome. And that's all she wrote, guys. You're officially a programmer. Now it's time to celebrate.
Today was a momentous day in programming education. My viewers have listened attentively, practiced diligently, and are committed to excellent professional coding habits. It is my pleasure and the pleasure of programmers everywhere to welcome you to the ranks of Legit Developer. May you print your award certificate and display it with the same pride that I have in you. Remember, your ideas are unique, valuable, and worth building. You have the power to make it happen if you just believe in yourself. This is Amberly, signing off. See you next time.